Organizing your file structure is essential to the effective use of includes. If you have includes scattered all over the website, it is easy to get confused and lose track of them. The include and require functions are somewhat picky when it comes to the location of files. The first place that an include will check for a file is the directories that are set in the php.ini file. The default for this is typically dot, which denotes current directory, and then user local php lib php. What I tend to do for my sites is define where my include files are. So that is the first place that is checked. Then it is a simple case of discipline to keep all the include files in the same directory. The directory structure that I use for my sites is all regular site files go in the files directory. All includes go in the includes directory. And any administrative functions or an administrative site goes in the admin directory, where the files, images, and includes directories are all replicated to keep that separate from the front end. To define your include path, you can use the ini set function. You can do this at the top of every page, but if that ever changes, you need to change this on every page. It is easier if you set it in one included file. I call this the definitions file. This file holds site-specific configurations such as database connections, definitions for paths, and server-specific settings such as error checking and include directory definitions. This file is either in the root directory of the site or within the files folder. Here's a look at the definitions file we'll use for this sample. There are only two settings to start with: the base directory, which is defined here, and that sets the server path from the server root to the site root. And then we have the include path through an ini set. This will add this path, which is base directory plus includes directory, which will bring us here. Adds that to the include path in the php.conf. This will allow us to call includes without typing out the full path every single time. So what I'm going to do is place the definitions file inside the files directory, right in here. You can now see the definitions are inside the files directory. Since only one file, which is the index file, will be outside of the files directory, I can include the definitions file the same every time on every page with include definitions.inc.php at the top of every page. That'll set up any other additional includes I have for that page. Now, another note about site structure is to notice the file extension in the definitions file. If you notice, the extension is .inc.php. I have the .inc there to denote that it is an include file, and the .php there as a security feature. If I did not have the .php there, then someone directly calling the .inc file could potentially see all of the PHP code if the server is not set up directly to handle that extension properly. For example, let's call a file definitions.inc from www.realworldprogramming-thebasics.com/05/02/definitions.inc. So you see, when we call this page, you can see the PHP code is spit out to the page because the web server isn't set up to deal with the .inc extension, so it just treats it as text. You can see the obvious security problem here, especially if you have database settings and passwords in this file. So what, you say? They'd have to guess the file name, where it is. Do you want to take that chance? By simply adding a .php extension to the file, voila, no more settings. The file is safe from prying eyes. In the end, it's your choice, but from my experience, you want to have that .php extension on the end of all of your include files.